Skype is an awesome communication tool that can connect you to your loved ones or anyone else feeling like you're right there in person. It's similar to FaceTime for Apple, but it's been around for a lot longer. One of the major differences between Skype and FaceTime is you don't need Apple products to communicate with each other. There are multiple ways to use Skype. You can use Skype on your mobile device, such as your iPhone, iPad, Windows, or Android phone. You can also Skype on your desktop computer. In this video, we will show you how to Skype on your desktop computer. All you need is a webcam and a microphone installed. You can also use a laptop, which we'll be using in this video. Depending on your particular laptop, you might already have a webcam built in. If you are on a computer, the first thing you'll want to do is download the latest version of Skype software by going to www.skype.com. Click on the download button. I am on a Mac, so my computer recognizes that and is automatically giving me the option to download the Mac version of Skype software. You might be on a Windows computer, so you would download the Windows version. On the Mac, I can see that the software is downloading in the bottom left-hand corner of my screen. Once it has downloaded, I will open it up. If you don't see it on your computer, you might want to do a simple search for Skype by typing the name Skype into your Finder window. Skype will open up and you might be prompted to enter your password if you've ever opened Skype on your computer before. If you are opening Skype for the first time, which is probably the case, you will want to create an account that is the blue link next to the words "no account" with a question mark. You'll then choose your region, which it's defaulted to United States, enter your phone number, and then create a password. You can also set up an account using your email address instead by clicking the blue link, use your email instead. Then click the next button. You will next need to verify your phone number by entering it again when you're prompted. So if you set up your account using a cell phone, then you will enter that cell phone number again and you'll receive a text message on your cell phone giving you a 4-digit code. You'll use that code to enter it on your computer. This is the process for verifying yourself from another account, such as your cell phone. If you choose to set up your account with an email address, you'll receive an email that you need to reply to in order to set up your account. Once your account has been verified, you will see a notification on your screen, and then you'll be prompted to link your computer's contacts to your Skype account.